Hello, guys and gals. Me, Mudahar, and I need a real pick-me-up today. Today was a bad day. Let me tell you something about losing. Loss is just something that you can never process properly, ever. But you know what, ladies and gentlemen? Today was, while it was a bad day, we did finally come across something that could potentially cheer me up. Ladies and gentlemen, remember a while back we looked at the Super Mario Brothers movie where we looked at a bunch of castings like Jack Black as Bowser, great choice, and then you had our old boy Chris Pratt as Mario. Now, genuinely speaking, when it comes to Super Mario, I'm a fan of it. Look, I have never taken an autism test, but my love for Sonic and Mario, definitely, I should take one after you could ask me all the lore about Sonic the Hedgehog and this plumber. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you know, I was always told Mario was a family-friendly franchise. I've never really come across a real proper argument for it. Something about this crazy, you know, mushroom abuser and animal abuser suddenly being family friendly never gets me. But you know what? After I played through Mario Odyssey on the Steam Deck, you know, just because I can and because it absolutely makes Nintendo fanboys piss and cope and seethe and cry, now we've got the Mario trailer, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go. Now here's Universal Pictures, you know, a kingdom releasing the Mario Brothers trailer. This is 2 hours ago. This is a fresh, spicy trailer. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I wanted to watch it with you, just some key points, and sort of go over a few things. But I think most importantly, you know, and I know, we're trying to hear a certain voice. Let's get down into it, okay? Now, obviously, it takes place with our old friend Bowser dropping down. You know, he's got the little battle pass as well. Bowser is definitely dropping near Tilted Towers. And of course, that kingdom up there, it ain't having it a good time. Now, of course, obviously the animation work is absolutely solid. I'd never doubted it. It's Universal Pictures after all. And you think they're going to skimp money on a Mario movie? Pfft, get the fuck out of here. This is worth more than anything. This is like a gold franchise. So let's hear Jack Black speak. Now, there's oftentimes a myth known as the brown noise, all right, a special audio cue to make people literally defecate themselves. Now, from what I've been hearing on the internets on the drive home, I've been hearing that this might cause some people to piss and shit themselves. So I want you, if you have weak constitutions, viewer discretion is advised. Let's listen to this. He's tripping.
What is this place?
Oh, it's not. Oh, he's not crazy Italian. Oh, no.
He's down in a bit New Yorker. Let's listen to it a little bit more. Hold on.
Do not touch that mushroom. You'll die. Oh, I'm sorry. That one's perfectly fine. Come on, Mario.
Mushroom Kingdom, here we come.
Oh, you know, I kind of like it. I'll be honest with you. I don't know what people are complaining about. Now, before we continue, we've never had a Mario is Missing film adaptation, okay? It's never gonna happen. Also, okay, the last time we had a Mario Brothers movie was live action. We had a Cyberpunk City, all right? I think Dennis Hopper was Bowser. Or we're never, ever going to get that again, okay? All right, as much as we all have nostalgia, that movie was just not good, okay? We're never gonna get it again. Now, this is much more what people expect Mario Brothers to be. Look, the visuals are all there. That's the Mushroom Kingdom, okay? Mario is sounding like a New Yorker, all right? You figured out the accent there? He's not as Italian as you expect. And you know what? I can accept that, okay? Chris Pratt, I feel like no matter how much blackmail you might have on Chris Pratt to make him agree to this role, all right, he's not going to just make the most goofiest European-Italian voice. It's just not gonna work that way, okay? That would be too offensive, ladies and gentlemen. I think the New Yorker voice makes sense, all right? And you know what? For all the New Yorkers out there that are offended, good. You can make fun of me too. Now, of course, ladies and gentlemen, I think it's a fine voice. All right, there's been some anger on the internet, as you can imagine. It's the internet after all. Chris Pratt as Mario is a prime example of why you should hire voice actors for voice acting roles. I agree. Don't get me wrong. I agree, okay? But the studio wants to make as much money as you can expect, and you gotta have that star power, okay? You ever wonder why Fast and the Furious sells? It's not because the story is any goddamn good. And I watched all those movies. Look, I like Fast and the Furious. I'm a Fast and the Furious enjoyer. But if you ask me to explain how good the storyline is, whoo, hell no. You know why it succeeds? Because they just got big actors and nice cars and hot women and crazy action scenes. Just like Mario's gonna have big name voices and good CGI. That's just how it works. Of course, you've also got other people who are like, he's literally just playing the same character he plays in every movie. God, I can't stand him. Okay, counterpoint. What other movie with Chris Pratt do we have where he plays as an Italian plumber shooting fireballs and is tripping on mushrooms? I think that's a pretty good point to bring on. Okay, I'm just asking. Okay, I'm making that point right here. Now, I gotta be honest, the CG work looks really good. Like, Luigi looks pretty awesome, all right? Just like every character, I think the Mario movie is gonna be pretty sweet. Listen, okay? Like I said at the beginning of this, I'm a huge fan of things like Mario and Sonic, all right? It's like the last good bastion to wholesomeness, okay? You know, these are the last two gaming franchises to not get battle passes and battle royales and, like, crazy high-level monetizations, okay? This is the last bastion of good gaming, all right? Proper gaming that you can have fun with the whole goddamn family. And anytime they release a Mario and a Sonic game, you bet that I'm absolutely buying them and playing them. I don't know so much about Frontiers. I'm a little jaded on it, but you know what? That's a whole different story. When it comes to the movies, honestly, this looks about as awesome as the Sonic 2 movie. And if you watch Sonic the Hedgehog 2, I think we all can agree that was a objectively good Sonic the Hedgehog movie, okay? And from what I've seen this trailer, you know, do I look like I'm out of the age range for watching Super Mario? Probably. But am I gonna go watch Super Mario? Absolutely. I'm gonna get the boys together, and we're gonna definitely get some tickets to watch the goddamn Mario Brothers movie together. You know why? Because it's a goofy, fun movie that we just all need to watch to take the load off. Ladies and gentlemen, this is me, Mudahar, and if you like what you saw, please like, comment, and subscribe. Dislike it if you dislike it. You know, normally I don't ask you guys to do any form of, like, you know, bullying or something like that, because I don't condone bullying. But if it's one entity I consider bullying, is cancer. Cancer is a terrible, terrible vixen out there. And, you know, if we can make fun of it together and call it the absolute piece of shit that it is, I would be very happy. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to end this video off with fuck cancer. If you like what you saw, I've already done that. My mind's all scattered. But you know what? The Mario movie, out of all things today... It did bring a smile. And sometimes that's all we need. This is me, Mudahar, and I'm out.